Does South Carolina need to change the way judges are selected? Why or why not?
We absolutely need to change the way judges are selected. The system now is, you know, you've got these lawyer legislators appointing judges. We need to go to a federal system, which I did sponsor when I was in the Senate before, where you have gubernatorial appointment with Senate oversight, advisory consent, just like the federal system. I fought against the current system. I actually spoke against a Supreme Court nominee in joint session, had 22 fellow legislators vote against the nominee, and later I was told by lawyer legislators that they could not vote against a sitting Supreme Court justice, so we definitely need to reform it.
Two, why hasn't South Carolina been able to improve the condition of the highways and bridges?
I authored the largest audit in the history of the DOT in 2015. I forced $200 million to roads in the budget when they were trying to raise your taxes. We don't need more money. We need to restructure the DOT. We haven't done it. We haven't taken into account the audit from 2015. There's a lot that can be done without spending more money. It just takes priorities. And we're spending money on things like ballparks and museums and all these things that are wants. But we got to take care of core government functions. And right now, we're not doing it. If I'm back in the Senate, I'll fight to make sure that happens.
Three. Would you support a school choice program that funneled taxpayer dollars into private schools?
I would definitely support that. I did support it when I was in the Senate. I feel like people need educational choice, and it's a situation where we've got kids that are trapped in failing schools. They need opportunities. I'm not faulting people in the public school system. There's a lot of hardworking teachers that do their jobs every day, but there needs to be choice, and I support that. I have supported that. I just think we need opportunities. Choice is always good for the consumer, and the children are the consumers in this thing, and they need an opportunity.
Four, would you support legislation to make gambling legal in South Carolina?
I would not support legislation to make gambling legal in South Carolina. We already have the lottery, which is gambling in this state, but one thing we're gambling on is these electric vehicles. We spent $1.3 billion as a state for electric vehicles. And now we see that Ford has lost $1.3 billion just in the first quarter. So I think this state is into gambling in all kind of ways, but when it comes to the taxpayers' dollar, we need to stop it. And these massive incentives, somebody in Columbia needs to look out for the taxpayer.